whatever.
Hello YouTube, this is Stefan for Bushcraft Holland. I'm doing a quick video for the steel I'm going to bring on my next winter survival. It's not really cold, it's minus 2 degrees maybe. But still, it's winter. And I decided to get rid of all the aluminium and take stainless steel instead. So, first item, the Stanley water bottle. Almost 1 liter, a plastic lid with a drinking device. You can put this one straight on the fire. Of course, take off the lid because it's plastic, it will melt. But you can cook in it. So that's coming with me. And this one is more like the SIG model, made in China, but stainless steel. Also 1 liter. This one is coming with me as a backup. As a drinking cup, I have this stainless steel coffee pad holder. But it acts real nice as a drinking cup, because even when the hot fluid is halfway up, the top will stay cool, so you won't burn your hands or lips. And also my water purifying system. This is the Water Camp Master, and the filter is in the lid. I'm bringing this one with me because I can scoop water straight out of the river and even without boiling it, sterilize it. And this will fit very nicely inside the cup, so the filter is protected. And the main part I'm doing this video is about this one. It's the Trangia Swedish Army pot and lid. The lid also usable as a frying pan, by the way. I ordered this one from Sipsdump. They said they had totally new ones, so I was interested and I ordered one. But a small mistake was made and they sent me a used one. This one is obviously used. So I called them today and I said, well, okay, I'm having this used one. I wanted the new one and I wanted to make a review during this weekend, what I'm going to do. They said, well, you can take this second-hand one we sent you. You can see the price tag still on there and use it for your review. And after you come back, you send it back to us and they will pay for post and package. And they will send me the brand new one. So that's good service. So I'm going to test the stainless steel version of the Trangia. Okay. This one goes on my trousers with the fire steel and my old trusty stainless steel with Alox handles. Swiss Army knife, soldier model, the one I used to carry during my military days. And also I'm going to bring this Holterforce heavy duty knife. I'm going to test it. I have tested this one in autumn, summer and spring. I'm now going to test it in winter. It was given to us by our sponsor Holterforce. So I'm going to test this one, see how it holds during winter time. I'm used to always bringing a backup knife, so that's what I'm going to do now. Normally I bring the F1 Valkniven, because I think it's the best backup knife you can ever have. But now I'm going to bring either this Enzo Trapper in D2 steel, which I modified, by the way, because I want to see how the D2 steel will hold in during winter time. Or I will take this Bernie Garland Woodlore clone in 01 steel. Not sure yet, I will decide tomorrow morning. I will bring my super tool, Leatherman super tool, as a Well, as a tool. And then for chopping wood, batoning, etc., I will bring my modified GI Tento by Cold Steel. I changed the blade, I changed the handle, I changed almost everything on this, but I'm a bit worried about Cold Steel saying to Late Boy Scout that the breaking of his leather neck, it was, he did this while batoning and it was called abuse by Cold Steel. I don't consider batoning abuse of a knife. I think when you are saying that you are making the best knives and the toughest knives of them all, that batoning should be a real option. So I'm going to, well, basically hit this one hard. I'm going to use it and abuse it for everything. And if it will fail me, this will be the last Cold Steel I ever bought, because I don't believe in making sentiments about, oh yeah, batoning, that's not for a knife. Bullshit. Because I'm not trusting Cold Steel anymore, just for their word, I'm bringing a backup axe. This is a Hulterford small axe. I'm going to bring this just in case the Cold Steel or any other knife will fail on me, and I, because it's winter time, I have to be chopping a lot of firewood. So this one, also for hammering, will be my backup. It will fit inside the side pocket of my backpack, by the way, because it's small enough. Okay, that's it for now. I'm trying to do some footage when I'm on the survival, and of course when I get back. So I hope to see you. Take care. Bye bye.
whatever.